something that is a grave concern in our society.
It's a season and a reason for everything.
I'm going above and beyond, so I'm not going to go above and beyond.
That's what we're talking about now.
No. You know right from wrong. You know how you felt. You caused that on someone.
In alphabetical order.
That is. No, I didn't. Did I?
Yes, you did.
Yes, I did.
Without that's even correct. Thinking about
okay,
it.
Okay, school teacher.
But you know, I'm in that ABC mode now. You know, school's back in.
ABC.
I know. And I don't do that. I put this thing on my board where if I make an error spelling something, because I'm always writing and trying mm-hmm. to write it so fast and talking, mm-hmm. and I put A to Z on the board, and the students will say, well, what is that? What does that mean? I said, A to Z, if I misspell something, you choose a letter between A and Z, and you fix it.
Oh, wait.
Oh, my. Okay, that's an interesting concept.
It is, because if they're astute enough to catch the fact that I've made an error, then they can go ahead and they can fix mm-hmm. it on their papers if they're taking notes mm-hmm. and I've left out a letter. And they say, oh, Miss Ketchup, you spelled that wrong. Okay, well, A to Z.
You remind me of my fifth grade teacher sometimes.
In what way?
She was fabulous.
In what way?
She was something else. She was Cheryl Lynn.
I need you to be more specific.
She was fabulous. She was fabulous.
I love my fifth grade teacher.
Okay, well, at least we know there was love. There was love.
She was hard. I mean, hard. And, you know, I don't want to tell my age, but.
Why not? You're old as dirt.
She had the
I'm just older.
Ruler. You know.
Oh, well, I don't have a ruler. I would like to have a ruler, but I don't have a ruler. But
and was not afraid to use it.
And you know, I really would not be afraid to use it. I might be afraid I might lose my job. But
you can go to jail.
No, you cannot go to jail. Corporal punishment is not illegal.
Okay.
Let me just say that. But that is not what our show is about today. See, they're trying to change the topic.
That wasn't me.
She was going into something totally different. That's a topic for another day. But for today, we are talking about that beauty, what makes us all fabulous. Our topic for today is called Made Over. And we are not going to give you any more details about it. We just want you to know that it's going to be a fabulous show. Fabulous. And it's not going to be a bunch of talking. So now, if that raises any eyebrows, that lets you know that you've got to continue to watch us, and you will get to see some of the fabulousness that's going to happen this evening.
Movie. What's the movie with the fat guy?
I like that fabulousness.
What is it?
Fabulousness.
Fabulousness. What's
that's going to be our
Ed Murphy. Ed Murphy. That's what they were saying on the show, the mama. Fabulous.
And, you know, Adrian has been giving us our word for the, oh my gosh. She's been giving us our words for the week and our game that we're playing, and we're hoping that you all are following that and that you are keeping a list of the words and that you're actually taking the time to define them. I don't recall whether or not we needed to include the part of speech. I know we needed to have a sentence with that.
Yes.
But fabulousness is not one of those words. So don't write that down and make an attempt. Just because the only thing that you could include under the definition of fabulousness is real women, real issues. We are full of fabulousness.
Mm-hmm. Oh my God.
And it's fabulous. Okay that some people don't get us.
It's cool.
I'm sorry, get me.
But what's also great is that
cool
we
that.
Don't have a problem saying that we are fabulous.
Ness.
I sure don't.
But in any case, I think it's about time to take a break.
Is it time for us to take a break already? I've just been talking about
it
just
is.
How fabulous we are.
It is.
We're going to be returning shortly. It is time for us to take a break. And when we come back, we're going to talk just a little bit around the water cooler, find out what's been going on. So make sure that you
what's
stay tuned
going?
With us. We'll be right back. Well, we are back, and we're so happy that you are continuing to watch. Before we went on our break, we gave you just a tidbit about our topic today called Made Over. And we were just having some general conversation, and I know that Josette has had some really interesting things going on this week, so we certainly want to hear from her and find out what is going on, girl.
I can tell you what's going on.
And we're not talking about Marvin Gaye, what's going on either.
What's going on? No, you had a job interview. She's a real woman living in the real world, and she's trying to make more money. Anywho, how'd your job interview go?
Terrible.
What? Why do you say that?
Really, it did.
Why? How? What?
Yeah, what happened?
Oh, gosh.
Well, first of all, I'm a little mad because I didn't even know you were going on a job interview. This is the first time I'm hearing about it.
You've been out of town and...
No.
I've been in town because I started back
working.
Things going
on.
But Sherilyn, also, you know, you have 6,000 children.
Yes.
So...
No,
you stay out of contact a lot.
I get text messages, emails.
Yeah,
I read them, Facebook, all that stuff.
But anyway, I just wanted to... Not saying that I'm looking for a position, I just wanted to see if I was
marketable.
Right. And went on the interview and tensed up. And you know, I'm gonna go there a little bit. I'm like Brown. You know, I was in the car and I had this conversation with myself and I said, self.
Yes.
You gonna go in there and you gonna show them who you are because you look good.
Wow.
And I did.
Well.
And I get in there and I tense up.
You know, that is so typical though of when we do job interviews. You know, we'll muster up all the confidence in the world, mm-hmm. and you walk in that room and you have this panel sitting mm-hmm. there, and all of a sudden you're like, what's my name?
Exactly.
I mean, were you really, really confident about what you were going to interview about, or was it a stretch?
I was so confident, even to the point I was in there sitting down. I had my little words together. Throughout the week, I went over my notes. I knew what I was going to say, how I was going to say it. And then I get in there and I just, my words was not coming out right. My complete sentences, and I do know how to speak English, were not coming
sometimes
out right. And I just couldn't answer the question.
I mean, did you answer the questions or just were you stumbling? I mean, some of those things are...
I did some of everything, I think.
Really?
Yeah. It was terrible. I beat myself up since
last week. So did they say, don't call us, we'll call you?
How many people were on the panel?
Three
people.
Okay.
Were they intimidating the way they looked or something?
But did they give you... I mean, sometimes we can be harder on ourselves than we really need to be.
I'm always hard on myself.
So did they give you looks that indicated that they were in agreement? Was it a look of,
Or was it a frown?
Was it...
It was like,
oh my gosh. You put me...
You did bad. You really did bad. I mean, I love to support you, but I don't think you did so good.
Them to sleep.
Were they yawning like that for real?
One of them did.
Ooh.
What was the time of the interview, the time of day?
Early in the morning.
Well, maybe they hadn't had their first cup of coffee, okay? Let's just be positive thinking. They didn't have their first cup of coffee, okay?
Good for you for continuing to go ahead. We support you, Josette.
Thank you.
You go on another interview, girl.
But I can tell you this.
What?
That ain't stopped me. And I said, ain't. That ain't stopped me. You know, I'm determined, you know, and I'll do it again. I'm just, like I said, I graduate tomorrow, and I just wanted
to graduate from. Okay.
Oh, you didn't know that either.
You didn't know that either.
So
I will be
real women audience.
A college graduate.
Real women, real issues audience. You all are getting the information at the same time as I, because I don't have any clue as to what she's talking about a graduation. Now we sit here together.
I am so sorry.
And they're gonna try to say it's because I have 5 children and I'm so incredibly busy, but there's no excuse for that.
She really
and
is.
I am really feeling as if I've been left out. Are you feeling left out? Oh my gosh, please send me an email and let me know that you, as well as I, are feeling left
but
out
I'm
together.
Not a person to
real
brag.
Women, real issues at yahoo.com.
I'm not a person to brag or think, you know, and I'm working on that.
But it's not a matter of bragging, it's just a matter of sharing good news with friends.
Communicate.
Now, first of all,
open communication.
We have to go to a break, but before we go to that break, I want to recap some things to all of our real women,
Women Real Issues audience members who have been with us along the road when she has had to have 100 on a test and yes. coming here acting insane and crazy.
Yes.
So we have been through that together. So how could I not be informed about the graduation, the completion of the program after I had to be beat up? So it's time for us to take a break, and I'm going to beat her up while we're on break. Y'all stay tuned to see what she looks like after we return. Well, we're back, and before we left for break, I was blasting Josette about the fact that I was not informed that she was completing a program, and I know you all did not know as well. And I need for us to do a close-up on Josette because I had to handle some things.
Oh,
I need for us to see what I had to do. You see her glasses a little
goodness.
Crooked. I had to handle that over break. So I'm going to tell all of you out there, our Real Women, Real Issues audience, I don't know why I can't get that right today, but
ladies.
If there are things going on with you that we need to know about, you need to let us know. You need to email us at realwomenrealissues@yahoo.com or send us a message on Facebook or Twitter. We need to know what's going on, because if you do not let us know what's going on, I'm going to have to handle it like I just handled Josette.
Gosh. You can reach us by airways. You can reach us by railways.
She's going to break out in song. Oh, my goodness.
You can reach us. Just get there however you can.
I did apologize.
It wasn't enough. And so now, I had to break her glasses. And that brings us into our money.
But wait. No, quick. Before we go to that, I do want to say this, though. After working with Josette for years, what seems like millenniums, but it's years, I will say this, whether she did well during the interview or not, whatever she puts her mind to, whatever task that has to be done, I can guarantee you this, it shall be done.
Yes.
You gonna hire me?
If I had an opening, let me tell you, I would actually hire you. Now, I may have to tie something around your neck to keep you in your... I'm just kidding.
Oh, goodness. You need some duct tape.
I'm just kidding.
Duct tape. And I don't mean for her mouth. You might have to duct tape her hands. This shouldn't even be productive. She come to work. She's absolutely right. She's going to get it done by any means
necessary.
You're
gonna get that job done.
That's that Malcolm X mentality. By any means necessary.
The job will be done.
I'm sorry.
And it will be done with excellence.
It will.
I have no doubt. It will,
by
be,
any
done. It will be done
It
with
will
excellence.
Be done by mm-hmm. any means necessary.
So,
now, moving on before she has an opportunity to respond
when
to that.
When they come back, y'all gonna see the knots on their head. Okay.
Oh, my gosh.
Love, ladies, love.
Yes.
Love.
Okay.
We're talking about beauty.
It's time to talk about our money matters, because your money matters to us and our money matters to us.
Yes.
And for, you know, a good example of that would be, you know, for Josette to always keep us informed, because she will have to waste money replacing those eyeglasses every time I break them. So that is a savings tip. Keep us well informed. So that you don't have to waste money. Don't waste money out there.
I am so glad you have good insurance.
But ladies, we got to find teaching your teens about money. Now, you have teenagers.
I have a teenager.
Well, you know, she has so many children.
You have a preteen.
I have a preteen, but that teenager, she does really well with money. You know, when I don't have cash, I haven't had time, because, you know, I told you all, and this is going to be a topic that we're going to actually talk about, money matters. But I don't use checks, and I don't have an ATM card, so everything
smart
that I spend is
lady.
Cash.
Smart
and
lady.
We have to actually go in and get money, physically go in. So,
oh, that's an inconvenience.
But it makes you rethink some things. But that's a whole different issue. But whenever I need a little cash, if I forgot to go or I didn't have time to go, Brittany, you think I can borrow? What you got? You got $40 I can get from $100?
Oh,
girl, that's big money. And she does things. She gives. When we go to church, she gives. Mm-hmm. She is not selfish with her money. If I borrow some money from her and I'm just trying to get to the bank, she's not one of those ones, Mom, I need my money. You got my money?
Well, does she pay you interest? Or do you pay her interest, I mean?
No, I just constantly give. Oh, okay. You got to keep putting money in the well, so when you need to go to the well, it's on there.
Well, how do you feel? One of the items on the list, they suggest that your teen may need to have a job. What do you think about your teenager working?
I I think it's fabulous. Mm-hmm. However, I don't want her working during school. Mm-hmm. You know, we have some objectives that we are trying to accomplish. So working during school, I think, is a hindrance mm-hmm. to prevent her from being able to do that. And to really focus on her schoolwork, she's, you know, really, really busy. But during the summer, I absolutely think it is a good thing for young people to be working. And we're going to continue this topic when we return back from our break. So we want you to stay tuned. Don't move.